Hello and welcome, it's Pamela here. Today I've got a really fun and easy mixed media project that I want to share with you. I do hope you'll give it a try, as not only is it great for beginners, but it's also a really good way of using up your scraps. As you may know, I've recently created some art journal pages using Stamperia's Wintertales rice papers. And I was left with some of these gorgeous cards, which are simply too pretty to waste. So I thought it would be a nice idea to add them to some small 5x7 inch canvases that I have, and I'm going to add some extra embellishments from my stash. I'll add the names of what I'm using to the top of the screen, and I'll play music throughout the video, but I will be back to explain anything that I think is important to note. I'm always really happy to share tips and techniques with you, so if there's anything you think I've missed out, please feel free to ask me in the comments, or just let me know if you plan to make something similar yourself, as I'd love to hear it. If you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up, as it helps my channel reach more people. Thank you. So to start, I'm tearing around the images rather than using scissors, as it will help the rice paper blend into the canvases better. I'll be gluing them down using transparent gesso, and I'll apply quite a liberal amount both underneath them on the canvas and then over to seal them. There's no need to prime the canvases first, as that's already been done. But if you buy canvases that haven't already been pre-primed, just be sure to apply a thin layer of gesso to them. It'll give a much better surface for your mediums.
Thank you.
Once they're dry, I'm just taking some white gesso and going around the edges of my rice paper to help it blend in even more. I want to add some texture to the empty space around the images, so I'm using this Baroque stencil and some modelling paste. This will give a really gorgeous effect. If you're new to mixed media, I would definitely suggest using stencils and trying out different paste, as it's so easy to do and it's a great way of adding dimension. Once my modelling paste is completely dry, it's time to add some colour, and as I want quite an opaque coverage, I'm using impasto paints. And I know this shade of blue looks quite shocking, but I will be toning it down once it's dry. Thank you. So the next step is to dry brush on some more impasto paint. This shade really complements the images and helps to tone down some of the vibrancy of the blue. I'm applying it with a dry stipple brush and I'm using really light, quite long strokes. And I keep my brush moving in just one direction as I don't want complete coverage. I'm just looking to get a light wash of colour and to pick up some of the gorgeous texture of the stenciling. So I've put the canvases to the side for now and it's time to start working on some of the embellishments that I'll be adding. These are chipboard pieces that I've already applied a layer of gesso to and I'm just going to add some colour with acrylic paints. Thank you. I want to add some extra sparkle and dimension to some of the pieces, so I'm going to heat emboss them using Cosmic Shimmer embossing powders.
Thank you.
Now that all my embellishments are ready, I'm about to start attaching them to the canvas along with some prima flowers from my stash, and for this I'll be using heavy body gel. This is a really great medium to use as a glue for mixed media work, as it dries to a really strong hold but has quite a bit of wiggle room beforehand. Once all my embellishments are attached, my canvases are almost complete with just one more step to go. So I'd just like to take a quick moment to say thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up before you go. And if you haven't already, why not consider subscribing for more papercraft and mixed media tutorials. Don't forget to stick around until the end of the tutorial, where you'll see that I apply a thin layer of gesso over all of the embellishments and the canvas. This helps to blend all the elements together really nicely and adds to the wintry feel. I really do hope that you like how this project turned out and you're inspired to create something similar. Until next time, take care. Bye bye.